my process is probably quite different than most people's. First of all, I'm never not writing. I'm probably writing now. I really mean that. I just don't know it. Because usually at some point during the day, at the end of the day, at night, 4 in the morning, it doesn't matter, I will go to the keyboard and whatever was in me that day will come out. You know, because I've written for pop artists and for the theater, it's two completely different disciplines. You know, when you're writing for pop, you know, you got to get to the hook in 45 seconds and it's 3.5 minutes and it's all the kind of Clive Davis 1 through 10 that you do to do that. If you're not an artist yourself, you really only make a living if you're writing kind of singles, you know, for artists, even back then, you know, even in the 80s and stuff like that. So that's that muscle, you know. In the theater, of course, the music has an entire different responsibility to the piece, whether it's helping to move the story along or set a place or a time or give you emotional insight. So that's a whole different set, right? But throw all of that away, because really for me, at the end of the day, writing is this kind of visceral, sensual exercise that I've loved to do since I was 15 and that I don't do any differently today than I did then. You know, and I'm just, like I said, I am influenced by everything and anything and everybody, and I throw it all into a pot, and you know, you feel different days, and you just go to it. So for the first part of my career, it was very free form, and very just, you woke up in the morning, and what did you feel, and you just started writing. And then what happened was, I had a great, there's a publisher named Roger Gordon at Warner Chappell in the 70s in LA, and he used to say to me, great exercise for writing is write the 11th song on a record. In other words, back then almost everybody had 10 songs per record, right? So pick any artist, 10 eclectic artists, listen to that album and write the 11th song. I found that to be something I use today and that I teach, and I say that all the time. So that was a wonderful experience. And then of course, you know, then there's the free form stuff, and then for theater, it's a whole different thing because it's almost like, you know, you have to write for this scene, or you have to write for the director wanting this here, and all of that kind of stuff. So it's using different muscles, and that at the same time, it's still a very visceral exercise for me. I always describe writing like fishing. The fish are there, and I go fishing. And some days you catch a big one, and some days you don't catch anything. You know, it's that kind of thing. But I really feel that way. I feel it's always there, and then I got to go find it. And that's kind of my process.